I'm an American who is infinitely prouder to be of African descent, no question about it. No question about it. I'm an Afro-American, and I don't use the word American ever loosely again. But I'll get to Nigeria later.
Mr. Evans, do you feel that Africa is to some extent an affinity for it, a home, or do you still feel America is essentially your home?
I would say that unquestionably I am an American, born there, my father's slave there. Upon the backs of my people was developed the primary wealth of America, the primary wealth. You have to have accumulated wealth to start, you know, to build. Mm. You did it another way here in Australia. You had to build your accumulated wealth too. Mm. You just came and took it, you know what I mean? And that's what they did in most of the countries. That's what you Europeans did. You just took it. We got to catch up with you a little bit. And so in America. So there's a lot of America that belongs to me yet, you understand? Mm. But just like a Scottish American is proud of being from Scotland, I'm proud for being African. Now, in our school books, they tried to tell me that all Africans were savages. Till I got to London and found most of the Africans I knew were going to Oxford and Cambridge and doing very well, and learned their culture. Yeah. And even once somebody had the temerity, after one had conquered the Chinese people and imposed upon them the opium trade and everything else, to suggest that they were backward people, just the people who had been civilized so long over the rest of you folks didn't make any sense at all. So somewhere, it was wonderful to find about the colored peoples of the world that they were very advanced. So I would say today that I'm an American who is infinitely prouder to be of African descent, no question about it, no question about it. I'm an Afro-American, and I don't use the word American ever loosely again.
Now, this was the feeling
That's right.
That when you...